Myriane Samson.
Five skaters remain. Cynthia Phaneuf has set the standard. That's the mark to beat now. 148.36. Mark combining the free skate and the short program. And on the ice, the year that Cynthia won the Canadian women's title, Myriane Samson won the Canadian junior women's title. She has made her name here this week. She is the new arrival to the senior scene.
Internationally, she has competed on the Junior Grand Prix circuit and has been the highest ranked Canadian lady, finishing fourth twice. But she's going to have to skate better than she did there if she's to hit the podium tonight. Oh boy, a little wild on that double axel, but you can see she can jump. A very athletic skater. She's got to calm down a little bit. She's going into her triple lutz combination here. Wow. Left off the second jump, but that's okay. She can add that jump in later. Now her triple flip. Yes. Two of the most difficult triples at the beginning of her program. Five triples planned in this performance. Here comes a triple salchow. The triple loop.
Oh yes.
Triple double.
Now she's knocking them off here.
And look at her smile, because the hard work's done. Now it's about keeping your focus. In the corner, any jumps now, 10% bonus.
Myriane is 18 from Saint-Jean-sur-Richelieu. 11th at last year's Nationals as a senior.
She has a second triple lutz planned, and she's changed it. Was going to do a salchow and turned it to a double. Here, and you have to be very careful with this new system with adding in jumps. You can end up not getting credit for them. She's got to play it smart. A real shot here at the podium. She has all the attributes of a world-class skater in the making. Wonderful athletic body and style of skating, but she also graceful arms, good performer, and she's showing us in this competition, landing the jumps.
Wow. Wow. She has been the X factor here all week. Has been outstanding in practice. Myriane Samson. Biggest surprise here.
tonight. If she can unseat some of the more powerful skaters, and it could happen here. Clean skate, nice skate. Leslie Hawker had her skate last night. Can she repeat that here tonight? Mira Leung, always good in the free skate. She knocks down a lot of triples. She'll need them here after Myriane Samson just did what she did. Every skater on the path to what could become a championship down the road needs a week like this, a breakthrough week. This is it for Myriane Samson.
She stood out for me on practice. When I watched the first ladies practice, I thought, okay, she has come such a long way this year over last season. She was 11th at Canadians last year. Look at this, triple Lutz. Really a strong jump. She had planned to do some more jumps in combination, but left them off early on and started to change her program a little bit at the end. She landed four triple jumps, so she's going to be very, very happy with her overall performance. Had she been able to get that fifth one in, she'd have a much better shot at that podium and Mira Leung and Leslie Hawker. Nonetheless, this is a skater who is going for a top five for the national team, but also a spot on the junior world team. I think she's good enough to represent Canada at Senior Worlds.
Two women will represent Canada at the Worlds in Tokyo, Japan in the spring. And, of course, everyone looking down the road to Vancouver. She needs 96.43 to move into first place.
So at the end of her program, she was supposed to do a second triple Lutz, decided to change it at the last minute into a Salchow and turned it to a double. And that's what can happen if you're inexperienced and you change on the fly. It takes a mind of Elvis Stoiko to do something like that. But, hey, she was trying.
Here's what can happen, though, as we've seen in women's free skates here in the past, is that while some skaters could rise, we have also seen some skaters crumble in the spotlight and nerves, you know, play havoc with them, and sometimes they fall. So we may see some skaters rise up and, you know, bite into that deficit, and others come back to the field. We'll see what happens. And Joanny Rochette still to come, and, you know, you would think that she's the overwhelming favorite to win, but again, it, as we've seen in skating, nothing is a for sure. So marks are coming here.
What's so great to see, though, more skaters like this, it just raises the bar for all of the skaters. Competition just breeds success. Technical elements.
Let's see what happens. 96.43. How close will she be to Cynthia Phaneuf, who was just behind her? And look at this. She is not. She, in fact, is in second position. Do you agree with that?
Well, that will come down to the second set of marks. Again, the component scores, leaving off that triple at the end. She had four triples to Cynthia's three. And Cynthia had a very clean, polished performance with full levels on her spins, full rotation and speed. So that's where Cynthia snuck ahead of her.